I have a hard time telling if, like, go out loud. I can't say this correctly. No! I didn't go that way yet. Oh, you jerk. I might just screw things up. Or maybe. Maybe not. Oh. That just makes them go forth properly. I think they counterbalanced. Oh, really? You know, maybe the commentary will provide at least one clue.
This map is all about themes and the action the player does are meant to reflect what happens in the diary entries. The player needs to turn the valves in order to progress, but at the same time, things go bad every time this is done. The level gets darker, the sound of someone being trapped gets louder, and the warp lurker seems to become closer. Everything tells the player not to turn the valves. Yet it must be done. Something that reflects how Daniel feels in the diaries.
To some extent, also it can be used for all sorts of purposes.
Like the grip?
Well, that too. But mostly to run different machines.
Ah, like water mill.
Exactly.
Okay. Water monsters. Water monsters might be able to. Okay, I don't think I can make that again. This is going to scare you a lot. Thank you. Oh my god, what? Maybe they aren't long. Oh, they're here. Oh,
7th of August, 1839. There is no denying that Alexander puts a lot of faith into what I can only describe as magic. I'm not surprised. Even while traveling across Europe, I assumed I would have to embrace the supernatural to save my mind and life. As a novice, I do everything in my power to stay focused and not dwell too much on my own doubts. Alexander woke me up early and told me it was time we got started on our work. He was obviously excited to get going, and we headed downstairs to the old dungeon where he preferred to attempt his rituals. It turns out that Alexander is a true Renaissance man, paralleled only by Da Vinci, I'm sure. He showed me several rooms fitted for specific research, such as anatomy studies, alchemy, and botany. The crown of Brennenburg must be the inner sanctum, a most hallowed ground where we shall attempt to permanently banish the orb's shadow.
Okay. Oh, that's what it's doing. Okay, okay. Okay, yeah. Going into the water is not what I want to do. Oh, wait, how am I going to get this one down? I should probably keep my eye on now. Yeah, make sure that's running the video. Oh, is it frozen? Okay, I'm not exactly watching the video feed. Maybe that's a good idea now. Thank you. Oh, hey. Somebody commented maybe. That's exactly what I was thinking when he was, like, when he was, like, talking about, like, I don't even know what it was. I'm not detail-oriented. Oh. Okay, well, see you later, then. Okay? I'll call you Frank for a while. But, apparently, you're gonna be back sometime soon, because, like, this is supposedly, like, a really scary part of the game. Okay, so... Alright. Good go. Oh, wait, what? What am I even standing on? I'm standing on Airman. Look at the Airbender. Flash Jesus. Okay. Get your desk, but it's looking up there. Is this the thing here? Oh. How do I make this thing that it was? You know, Alexander, wait, Daniel was the main character. Right? Or is that? I think it's Daniel. Right? I think Daniel's a dog. And I think he's an INTP, but he's an ISTP. But he's like in the question. It's too far.
8th August, 1839. I could never be certain until today I was on the right path. Using my orb, Alexander managed to channel its power unto us. The inner sanctum flared with blue, fiery light, and I could feel the same things I felt in the dark chamber in Algeria. It was like standing in a mad whirlpool of impressions.
Oh, it's amazing.
It was terrifying. But Alexander kept calm and wielded strange tools of science in order to tame the storm.
What is this metaphor?
Suddenly, the blue light was stained by strains of red, and the walls burst with pulsating tissue resonating with the scene. Alexander quickly covered the orb in some cloth, and the unspeakable thing vanished. Apparently, the orb's shadow is closer than Alexander thought. He said I should prepare for a warding ritual tomorrow. I'm not sure what he expects, but I have a bad feeling about this.
We're certain about you're on the right track. Yeah, that makes sense, buddy. He's the most caring officer. Okay. It seems like every time this happens, the door becomes a little bit less blocked. There's a good news. Then you're poetic. You're going to get one from the outside.
I'm going to voice that way for a reason. I think that's what I'm going to do.